Hey everybody, I'm back, and this is Processor, and I have discovered the best Chrome tablet that I have ever used. It has amazing hardware, it runs on an ARM processor, so it has pretty good battery life, it supports LTE natively on the device, it actually works in tablet mode instead of the janky fiasco that you usually get on Chrome OS. If web apps don't cover all of your needs, you can also use, you can also use Windows apps, because yeah, the best Chromebook I've ever used actually isn't a Chromebook, and I'm not actually using Chrome. It's this thing, the Surface Pro X using the new Edge browser. So here's a question. Dieter, are you feeling okay? Look, let's get this out of the way right at the top. It's super important that you understand that I am not telling you to buy this computer. I am definitely not doing that because as spec'd, this costs more than $1,700. And even though there are some discounts on it right now, whatever, it's too expensive. Plus, you know, I've already reviewed this computer and I decided that the app problem is really serious. It uses an ARM chip, which means that there are some app compatibility hassles. So why am I looking at this again? Well, there's now an official version of the Edge browser, and more specifically, there's an official beta of the Edge browser that uses ARM code directly, and of course it has the Chromium engine. See, the ARM chip on this hardware means that a lot of Windows apps run in emulation, which kind of kills the battery life and it slows down the apps, and some apps don't even work at all, like Lightroom. But now there's a good Chromium-based web browser that runs native ARM code, and so what if I just use this thing to run web apps? And what if instead of struggling with all of the hassles that come from all that Windows emulation stuff, I just treated this thing like a Chromebook and only ran Windows apps when I really needed them? Well, I'll tell you what, if I did it, and I think I learned some stuff along the way. So the main thing is that this thing runs Chrome, it runs the Edge beta browser really, really well. I regularly have 20 plus tabs open and it's really not breaking a sweat. I especially love how easy the Edge browser makes it to create apps out of web pages. If you have a PWA like Twitter, there's just a little button right in the URL bar that you can click, and other pages if you want to make an app, there's no weird thing to find. There's literally an option in the menu that says, make this an app, and you just click it and bang, it shows up in your taskbar. Also, the Edge browser supports Chrome extensions, so all of the stuff that I'm used to using on Chrome works before, and you can grab those Chrome extensions directly from the Chrome store. So I went and I grabbed this extension called Chrometana, which automatically redirects all Bing searches to Google searches, which means that you can actually use the Windows key to search Google without having to deal with installing a bunch of extra crap on your Windows computer like you did before. Last, and maybe most importantly, because this Edge beta is running on ARM code, it just natively works, it feels faster, and I think I'm getting way better battery life, like on the average of like 2 hours more than I was before, which is about where I expected battery life for this computer to be in the first place. Okay, so how does all that compare to a Chromebook? In fact, let's compare it to a really high-end Chromebook like my Pixelbook here. Well, instead of the kind of janky Android apps that you use in a pinch, you just get really good Windows apps. Like the Spotify app here actually works, and like the play pause button actually works. It unlocks with my face. I don't have to punch in a passcode or use a fingerprint sensor or whatever. And it doesn't suck as a tablet. Microsoft is really good at managing Windows. You can put stuff in split screen. You can move stuff around. When you go to the overview screen, everything flies around exactly where you expect it to be. It also, unlike the upcoming Galaxy Chromebook, has a 3x2 screen. Stylus input is way better because Microsoft has been doing stylus input for way longer than Chrome OS has. And it also has better privacy defaults than Chrome does. It's got a pretty good reader mode that hasn't come to Chrome yet. And Windows also has this Your Phone app, which means that this computer works better with Android phones than a Chrome OS computer does. If there's one major downside to using a Windows computer basically as a Chrome OS computer, it's that getting set up on a Windows computer still takes forever. And you gotta wait for Cortana to tell you that she's setting things up and blah, 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 blah. Whereas on a Chrome OS computer, you basically can get logged in and doing your stuff within a couple of minutes. Okay, so this is a lot of praise for this computer as a Chromebook. So once again, I really feel like I need to emphasize that you should not buy this computer. It is too expensive and too limited for what it does. But I do think we can learn from this experience of using it as a Chromebook. together. Microsoft is no longer trying to take over the world with Windows anymore. They're making their software for Android, and they're making the Edge browser for Mac, and whatever. Basically, Windows now is a platform that wants to run as many apps and many kinds of apps as it possibly can, and the benefit for Microsoft is that while you're doing that, it might convince you to sign up for some Microsoft stuff like OneDrive or whatever. So, you know, touchscreen apps? Cool. Web apps? You bet. Legacy Windows apps? Sure, they'll run on ARM. It might be a little bit messy sometimes, but it basically works. And if ARM processors really do start taking over Windows laptops and Windows tablets, it could show that there is a middle ground between the slow, frustrating ARM Windows computers that we've tried before and the very fast, very elegant, but very, very locked down iPad Pro. This is not that. Not yet. I mean, it still doesn't run Lightroom. But it proves that it's possible, and that honestly, it might not be as hard as we thought. Hey everybody, thanks so much for watching. Now, there is one Chromebook that I'm really interested in coming up. It's the Samsung Galaxy Chromebook. And even though it doesn't have a 3:2 screen, which is the best aspect ratio, yes it is, it's worth checking out. We've got our hands on of it.